Now we have to move on to classical production function. But before moving on to classical production function, let us focus on certain concept. So you have already studied these concepts and classical production function in your first year degree classes. But I'm just brushing up your knowledge. So we can just move on to the certain basic concepts in production function. First concept is total physical product, TPP. What is total physical product? It is the total amount of output obtained using different units of inputs. So using different units of input, what is the amount, what is the total amount of output obtained? So TPP or total physical product is the total amount of output obtained by using different units of input. So total amount of output, these are calculated in physical units like quintal, kilogram, etc. So total physical product is the total amount of output produced using different units of inputs. Second concept is average physical product. So average physical product is the average amount of output produced by each corresponding unit of input. So how can we calculate average physical product? So the calculation is similar to finding averages. So average physical product can be calculated by dividing total physical product by number of units of inputs applied. So average physical product, APP, is equal to total physical product by inputs used or input level. Here we can represent total physical product as Y and input level as X. So average physical product is total physical product by input level, that is Y by X. Next, let us move on to marginal physical product. Marginal physical product is the additional quantity of output added by an additional unit of input. If you are adding one more input, then what will be the changes made to output? So, it is the addition of quantity of output made by adding an additional unit of input. So marginal physical product is a change in total physical product by adding one more input. So MPP or marginal physical product is equal to change in total physical product by change in input level. So what is change in total physical product? Total physical product is represented as Y. So change in total physical product can be represented as delta Y. And change in input level can be represented as delta X, because we have represented input level as X. So MPP is equal to change in total physical product by change in input level. That is delta Y by delta X. Now let us focus on elasticity of production, EP. So elasticity of production is defined as percentage change in output as a result of percentage change in input. So elasticity of production is percentage change in output to a percentage change in input. So EP is equal to percentage change in output divided by percentage change in input. Now, how can we represent percentage change in output? So, change in output by total output into 100, that is percentage change in output. So, we have represented total output or total physical product by Y. So, percentage change in output is equal to delta Y, change in output by total output Y into 100. So percentage change in output is delta Y by Y into 100. And percentage change in input is change in input by total input into 100. We have represented input as X. So percentage change in input is delta x by x into 100.
So elasticity of production is equal to delta y by y into 100 divided by delta x by x into 100. So 100 is common in numerator as well as in denominator. So we can ignore the term. Then our elasticity of production is equal to delta y by y divided by delta x by x. So now we can take delta x by x into numerator by interchanging the term delta x by x as x by delta x, and by changing the symbol division by the symbol of multiplication. So here elasticity of production can be written as delta y by y into x by delta x. By interchanging the terms, we can write EP is equal to delta y by delta x into x by y. Here, delta y by delta x is marginal physical product. So this is change in total physical product by change in input level. That is marginal physical product, delta y by delta x. Now, the second term is x by y. We know that y by x is average physical product. So x by y can be written as 1 by y by x. Or we can write x by y as 1 by APP. 1 by y by x is 1 by APP. So first term is MPP and second term is 1 by APP. So MPP into 1 by APP is elasticity of production. So elasticity of production is equal to MPP by APP. So these are the important concepts in production function.